Ah yes, USB Type-C, the new USB standard that will save us from constantly having to try to put in the USB cable the right way. I'm sure most of you have heard of it by now if you haven't already been using it, but you probably don't know all the details, like what's the difference between USB-C and USB 3.1, or are all USB-C cables capable of doing the same speeds? Well, that's what we're going to talk about today, because even though all USB-C connectors look the same, there are a lot of different types of USB-C cables that you should know about. And believe me, it gets really confusing. I literally did about 5 hours of research for this video, but I'll try to make it easy to understand. First, let's start off very simple. What is USB-C? At its most basic level, USB-C just refers to this specific USB plug, plus some specifications for those cables' wirings, and that's it. So just saying USB-C only tells you about what the cable looks like. It doesn't describe any specific speed, power capability, or supported data protocol. It was basically designed to be a more modern, future-proofing plug. Most notably, the plug has more pins so it can do a lot more stuff, which I'll get to in a bit, and the plug is reversible, so you can't plug it in the wrong way. I mean, the whole joke with the old USB cables was no matter how many times you flipped it, you couldn't plug it in until you looked at it. And by now you might be thinking, all right, so it's just a plug. But there are three main criteria that will be very different between cables that we can talk about. Those are data speed, power, and protocol. And those three differences are what we're mainly going to cover in this video. Now, quickly, before we get into that, I should point out that even though USB-C doesn't describe any specific speeds or power capabilities, it does still have minimum specifications. For example, all USB-C cables should support at least 3 amps of electrical current and 60 watts of power. Also, because a USB-C cable is the same on both sides, it must obviously be wired so it can send data and power both ways equally, called dual roll, and this is important for later. And this is unlike previous USB cables where the host side, such as your computer, typically had a USB-A connector and the device side, like your phone, had some other connector like a micro USB or USB-B. So let's get into different possible speeds of a USB-C cable. You may already be familiar with USB 3.1 or super speed USB, which supports up to 10 gigabit speeds. But to be clear, USB-C is not USB 3.1. Again, USB-C is just a connector, while USB 3.1 and 2.0 and 3.0 are data transfer speeds. Instead, a USB-C cable will use one or more of those USB standards, and that could be 2.0, 3.0, 3.1 Gen 1, 3.1 Gen 2, and depending on the USB speed rating it uses, it will have a different maximum speed. That means that even though USB-C is the latest brand new connector, you could still have one that supports USB 2.0, and it will have the same maximum speed as regular old USB 2.0 cable at 480 megabits. Of course, you also may have ones that support USB 3.1, but it's not a guarantee. So you need to look at the labeling to see which speed it has. But one thing you can look for is if the cable is labeled as a full-featured USB-C cable. This term means that the cable supports the latest USB 3.1 Gen 2 speeds of 10 gigabits per second, and it's backwards compatible with USB 2.0 as well. And full-featured is an actual term from the specification document, so you can't just call a cable full-featured if it doesn't fulfill those requirements. Okay, so we know that those are different speeds for USB-C, but now let's talk about electrical power. As I mentioned before, any USB-C cable should have a maximum of at least 3 amps, though there is one exception being a USB-C to USB 2 mini B cable for some reason, which is 500 milliamps, but let's just forget about that one. Anyway, you may also have heard of USB power delivery, which allows for more electricity to be sent through USB and has more versatile charging capabilities of up to 5 amps and 100 watts. This is much higher than the standard 3 amp 60 watts that you get without it. But again, not all USB-C cables or devices for that matter will have power delivery. So as you can imagine, if the USB-C cable doesn't have it, the most you're gonna get is 3 amps since that's all the cable is rated for, even if the charger and device do it. And by the way, it doesn't matter what speed rating the cable is for it to have power delivery. It could be 2.0 or 3.1. Now, if your cable, charger, and device all support power delivery, it has some cool capabilities. Because you've got 100 watts to work with, you could, for example, charge much larger devices, like a monitor, without having to plug it into the wall, because all the data and the power is through the USB-C cable. Also, power delivery does more than just send power. It also communicates information about the connected devices between them, because if a cable or a device doesn't support power delivery, the power source will default to just 3 amps. But if it sees that it does support power delivery, it needs to know more, like how much electricity to use. All right, it's more than 3, but how much exactly, and how much at any given time. Also, power delivery can take advantage of the dual role ability of USB-C that I mentioned earlier. So a port may be used either as a power input or output, or even switch between modes quickly. This is why in the latest Macs, you can charge the Mac by plugging the power cable into any of the USB-C ports. And all of those ports can be used to power other devices themselves. So you gotta be sure that you know which devices and which cables support power delivery so you can charge at your maximum speed. All right, now the third topic I mentioned was different protocols that may use USB-C, and these are called alternate modes. And at the moment there are 4, DisplayPort, Thunderbolt, HDMI, and MHL. The first 3 you probably already know, but MHL is used for connecting smartphones to TVs. If you've ever seen a micro USB to HDMI adapter for a phone, for example, it probably used MHL. And just like before, any given USB-C cable may or may not support any of these protocols. And of course, these protocols won't necessarily use USB-C all the time. Obviously, DisplayPort and HDMI have their own connectors that you've probably seen. But I should point out that Thunderbolt 3 is actually going to be using USB-C exclusively from now on. But this is where it gets really tricky, because you can't just buy one cable that supports all of them. Each alternative mode has different capabilities, which are pretty arbitrary in their individual cables. Take Thunderbolt 3, for example. A Thunderbolt 3 cable can be used for USB 3.1, DisplayPort 1.2, and Thunderbolt, obviously, as long as you have a Thunderbolt 3 port. It can do it all. And any Thunderbolt 3 cable can also be used for USB 3.1, even if it's not a Thunderbolt port. But there are actually 2 types of Thunderbolt 3 cables that are both USB-C. There's an active cable, which does 40 gigabits, and a passive cable, which does 20 gigabit. Now, say you have a native DisplayPort jack on your computer. Not Thunderbolt, it's just regular DisplayPort. I just said that Thunderbolt 3 supports DisplayPort, so I should be able to use a Thunderbolt 3 cable with it, right? Well, the answer is maybe. You see, you can use a passive Thunderbolt cable with up to DisplayPort 1.2 ports, but you apparently can't if it's an active cable, even though they're exactly the same protocol, Thunderbolt 3, same jack, it's just one is active and one is passive. So in this case, it must be DisplayPort over Thunderbolt if it's an active cable. And if you can't follow that, well, just look at this simple, easy to read table, which tells you what cable types work with what modes. So yeah, turns out USB-C isn't gonna be as universal as everyone thought. In fact, I think in some cases, it's gonna be even more confusing. I mean, if you're just looking for a cable to use for moving data over USB, basically any cable will work. Though still, you have to look at the speed of it. But if you're connecting a monitor or something that uses USB-C, good luck. You'll probably have to use one specific type of cable that looks exactly the same as all the others, except for maybe a little logo on the end. At least nowadays, you can look at any cable and instantly know what it's for just by the connector, and you can be almost sure it will work. But with USB-C, I could totally see average people trying to use a basic USB-C cable for a monitor and having no idea why it won't work. They should at least be color-coded or something, kind of like how they have USB 3 plugs that are blue. Now, in general, I do think that USB-C is a positive step forward. I figure that in most cases, it will just be used for regular USB, so it'll be nice to know that if you buy some gadget, you'll be able to use it with basically everything else. I just wish they'd standardize the cables themselves. At least then you'd just have to worry about if the devices you're connecting are compatible, and not whether you're using the right cable that looks the same as all the others. And yeah, they will supposedly have little logos for the different types and speeds, but that barely helps because they always use these stupid names instead of giving the specs. USB full speed, USB high speed, USB super speed, USB super speed plus. It's like you have to memorize a chart of what names correspond with what speeds. Not to mention that high speed USB means just USB 2.0, which was released 17 years ago. I mean, at this rate, in another 10 years, they're gonna be calling it ultra super duper mega max speed USB. But anyway, enough rambling. Basically, just know that not all USB-C cables are created equal, and hopefully you learned all the different possible types that you might need or come across. So that's it. If you guys want to keep watching, I'll put some other videos right here. You can click on those even if you're on a phone. Also, let me know what you think down in the comment section and give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. And don't forget to subscribe. I make new videos at least 3 times a week, Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday, and also maybe enable notifications as well. I'm looking forward to hearing from you. And as usual, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Have a good one.